Oh, hey there, people. How's it going? Well, it's late in the Saturday afternoon. It's currently 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I got up mega late because, well, number one, didn't set alarm. Number two, don't got to do anything today. Well, except for go out and see if I can do something with a Trans Am. And number three, my day off, so I want to sleep in. And I did. For a lot. So, I'm gonna make myself a cavi. Holy crap, I gotta go back to bed. Like, I could actually go lay down right now and go back to bed. That's how bad it is. Anyway, I'm all that stupid out. It's so funny how different the weather is out there than here. Like, in here, it's nice and cool and it's not too bad. But then you go outside to let the dog out, and it's like a fucking heat wave. So, yeah. It's also not raining today, so the weather dick was wrong. I don't know, see how I feel after I drink my coffee. Probably gonna go outside and see what we can do with the Trans Am. I don't know if there's anything we can do in Trans Am for that matter. And just like yesterday, 10 more gold. This has been 3 days in a row. I got the hat trick for getting gold. This is awesome. So I'm trying to decide. It's almost 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Like I said, I got up late. And it feels good to sleep in, mind you. But I'm trying to decide whether or not I should go outside and start working on the pump. Or if I should wait until Monday, go to P&G, and see about getting another pump. Like, it's... I don't know, it's hit and miss outside. I'm not sure if it's going to rain or what. And I don't want to be home spitting when I let the dog back in. So, I don't know if I want to be out there working on the car in the rain. That, and I just don't feel like doing shit today, which, you know, a lot of you are going to comment on, and that's fine. I don't give a shit. But, if I can get a new pump from P&G for $50 or whatever, they're closed right now. They're not open on the weekend. They're not open now until Monday. I was going to give them a call and see if they have one in stock. And if they do, I could scoop that thing up and then slap it on the car and be done with it. Then all I need is a new battery for the car, and she should be able to start. Oh, I'd have to put some new gas in the tank. That's a given, because chances are the fuel that's sitting in the tank right now is probably turpentine, because it's been sitting for 2 years. But other than that, it should start and it should run. And then I just need to get insurance on it, which requires me to get an appraisal officer over here to write it. So that's the thing. I can't drive the car out of the driveway without insurance. And I don't want to put it on my current insurance, because it's going to be like pretty expensive every month. Like, it won't be no cheap rate. It'll be about what I'm paying on the G6 right now, which will be about $85 to $95 a month. So the way I see it is I'm better off to put it on classic car insurance, pay $200 a year, which will be about, you know, $16, $17 a month, and only drive it in the summer and let it sit in the winter. So, yeah, I just don't know if I feel like going outside and doing anything. It's a fucking muggy hot day out today, and I hate that about spring when it gets like this, because it's so damp outside and muggy and bleh, bleh. But, I don't know, I'm still tossing and turning. I'm thinking about making another coffee. And then going from there, because that'd be nice, more caffeine, and then I'll decide what I want to do. Because taking the pump off shouldn't be too hard, I don't think. Let me just look it up online and see how many bolts hold that thing on. So there it is there, and it looks like it has a part that goes, okay, no, that's where the air comes out of, and those two big holes, so it's got two bolts holding it on, and this is the part the belt goes on to, which is where the pulley attaches, and then, yeah. So that's where the air comes out of, that big hole right there. Then you got your two bolts that load it on. Personally, I just wish you could just remove it, put an idle pulley in there, and call it a day, right? For $20, you can buy an idle pulley. I just hate the fact that I have to have it on there. It only actually does its job in the first, what, minute and a half, 2 minutes tops of running. So it doesn't make any sense why I would need to have this on my car, when after 2 minutes, it literally doesn't really do much for the car anyway. But due to the laws up here, even though we don't have e-testing, your car has to be equipped with the original pollution control system that it came with. Unless it's registered as a hot rod. Like, for instance, if I were to take that 305 out and put either an older or a newer engine in, like an LS1 series, or like get an old 455 Super Duty from a Pontiac GTO that didn't have pollution control, then I'd have to register the car as a hot rod, and I would have to be under different classifications. But if you're running it stock like I am, 305 throttle body injected, LO3, and so on and so forth, all the original pollution control stuff has to be in there. They'll never rifle a wand up the exhaust pipe and check to see what the emissions are. They'll never hook it up to a computer to make sure it's running perfectly fine. All they care about is that all the original pollution control equipment, the catalytic, the air pump, The EGR system, all that shit is all in stock and all working properly, which my EGR valve, not so much. Sometimes it sticks. It sticks open. It's supposed to close at certain points, and sometimes it just doesn't. But that's when I get a service engine soon light, and then you just drive for a bit longer, and then it closes, and it's fine. So, yeah, I'm just trying to decide whether or not I want to go out there into that muggy hot. Like, right now, it's nice and cool in this room because I got the fan blowing hot air out, and there's cool air coming in. But you step outside, and it's just like a fucking vapor barrier of bleh, you know? And I'm trying to decide if I want to put myself up against that or not. One thing I'm not trying to decide is whether or not I want another coffee, because that decision was already made for me. So let's go ramp off another coffee right now.
Oh, look who came to see me. It does Gabbers. Okay, bye. You going downstairs? What are you doing? Gampers?
Her fur's starting to come back a little bit, I think. I don't know. I can't tell with you because you're a kitchen witchin'. But she doesn't have red spots all over her body anymore, so that's good. So it'll gradually come back. She seems happier now, I think. I don't know. She's a weirdo. Are you a weirdo? Yeah, you. Look at your face. Look at your face! What are you doing? I don't understand what you're doing. Are you just being cute? Is that what you're doing right now? Are you just being a cute kitten? Is that what you're doing? Oh my goodness. Trying to sniff the camera. Anyhoozle, I'm gonna fire off another coffee. So yeah, it's only 2 bolts to take off that part. I should be able to take it off. I just don't know if I'll be able to do anything with it today. Because to get to the garage bench, the workbench, I literally have to move the motorcycle. And so on and so forth. And I'm just, fuck, I don't feel like doing shit today. I just want to chill. And I know I'm going to get flack for it in the comments, so it's like, fuck, you never do anything, Adam. You never do what you're going to say. Blah, 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 blah. Self-righteousness. Blah, 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 blah. Other stuff and junk. Blah, 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 blah. And it's like, yeah, you're right. I never do what I say I'm going to say. Because I don't know how I'm going to feel the next day. But as you can see behind me, the sun is out. Yeah. So, I could go outside and start cranking on her, but I also could drink another coffee, chill out, and watch some more Top Gear, and just fucking relax for the weekend. I don't know, we'll see. There's still tomorrow, too, but it's a nice day out today. That's what I'm thinking about, getting out there and just taking off the pump. Because all I gotta do is release the belt and pull 2 bolts, and the pump comes off. Well, that's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping it's not, you know, somehow welded itself to the block. That, and I don't know what's underneath that part of the engine block. If there's like an air, like if it sucks air from inside the block somehow, or like, I don't know anything about this kind of shit. So that's where shit might get tricky for me. For last year, Rex came over the one day and I was like, dude, listen to this. And it was squeak, 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 squeak. And the video was, I started up the Trans Am because people were begging for a cold start because Dave Farm Addicts. So I did a cold start and the belt was just whispering away because of the fact that the pump was seized, so the belt was skimming across the pump and just chirping. Well, Rex and I managed to free it up by using some PB Blaster and shooting it into the pulley and then using a screwdriver to break it free. Fired up the car, got it spinning, and just kept adding lube to it as it was going, and it seemed to work. It seemed to free it up. It's probably seized again. The fact that the lube seized it up, or freed it up, means I could probably just take it apart, clean it, and put it back together, and it'd probably work fine. Saving myself some bucks in the long run. I'm just feeling kind of groggy today, but it's not because I drank my face off either last night. I only had 8 beers. That was from 4 o'clock until like 4 o'clock, so 8 beers over 12 hours, that's fuck all. Alrighty, let's go outside, and we'll see if we can get that pump actually removed. I just got confirmation from church that there's nothing behind it. It's just bolted right to the engine. So I was worried about like some sort of an air inlet that would have basically caused like it sucked air from inside the engine block or something. I don't know. Like I said, I'm not a mechanic. I'm just going to put on my shitty shoes. Now we're going to head out. Get the car open. See what we can do. Yeah, this was a thunderstorm today. Look at all the storming, eh? Freak's sakes. But, get this thing open. Get some light going in here. Get the big door open. Get this lawnmower out of the way. Start knocking everything over. Okay, I'm gonna move the barbecue and get the lawnmower out of here. Just so I have a clear path back to my toolbox. There's like just way too much shit in here right now. That's why I kind of want a shed. So in the summer I can move this into the shed and have all this extra room. And then in the winter I can move the lawnmowers to the shed and have all this extra room. But yeah, I guess I have high hopes. So I need to get this chair out of here. See, there's a whole bunch of room over here to put stuff. So, like, I need to do that. I just need to get this hose thing set up one of these days. Get these vacuums in the garbage. But that's for this old chair. I'm going to get her out of here. And probably put her at the side of the road, maybe. I don't know. But it's pretty much garbage. Had this chair since I lived at my parents' house. This chair's seen things. This chair could talk, let me tell you. It would talk a lot, but I'll get this fucking thing out of here for now, just so it's not blocking the way. And let's get the Trans Am open. Pop the hood. I don't know if I lock it or not. Apparently not. Obviously I don't care if things get stolen. Ugh. So much work to do in there. Gotta clean that shit up. Feels like it's sitting on its rims. Do I have air in the tires? Oh no, she needs air in the tires, that's for sure. Just feels so much lower than normal. What does this side look like? Looks like the tires are holding air, but she could use a pump up. There we go. Sometimes you gotta tenderize it to get it to open. Whether or not the struts hold it up. Yeah, the struts aren't going to hold it up. See, here's the thing. The pump is that one right there. That's going to be a hour and a half to get out. I don't even know how the fuck I'm going to do that. Okay, let me get something to hold this up. Okay, I just wedged a piece of wood between the hood and the thing. I don't even know how the fuck that thing comes off. I'm not even seeing where the bolts go. I don't even see the bolts. There's one way down there. So if I look just beyond this here reservoir can, yeah, I don't know. I really don't fucking know. What a pain in the cock, eh? I might have to take this whole fucking belt tensioner off. I think that's the belt tensioner here, this guy here. I think you're the belt tensioner. And last time what I did was I put a wrench on this and twisted it out. And the belt was loose enough I can take it off the alternator and then do what I needed to do. But I'll have to get a ratchet in there. I don't even know. I don't even know. Because you can see back here where my buddy built that plate and attached it on to run the hose down to the catalytic. Fuck, I don't know. This is where I need a guy. I need somebody who's familiar with this. This is not something I want to tackle. So I'm not sure what's the easiest way to approach it. And when I'm not sure, I don't like doing things. This is not my forte, people. Mechanics is not my forte. So I might leave this. I don't know. I might try what Rex and I did last year. All we did was we grabbed... The fact that the car's sitting this much lower, though, is weird. I don't recall it sitting this low to the ground. Struts are probably getting tired from Shows on the front end are probably getting tired, maybe. From being so old. Who knows? I should just get rid of this car. I don't need two cars, but anyway, enough bitching and moaning about it. Because I don't even see where the bolt is for that one, so I wonder if you got to do it from underneath the car. That's what it is. It's fucking weird. I might have to take this whole idler pulley right off, because it looks like it's mounted to the idler pulley. So that bolt there, and fucked if I know where the other one is. I have no idea. I don't know, people. I don't know. I might have to Google search this one, because last year all we did was, you see how they got the three bolts on that pulley? Well, Rex and I just, Rex grabbed us one of my big screwdrivers and wedged it between the three bolts and spun it, and then we squirted a bunch of PB Blaster behind, and that freed it up, and then it was good to go. Started it, ran it, spun, it was good. I don't know if I can do that again, but you see here, I need to replace my belt. Like, I don't know if you can see the cracks in it, but this belt is fucking done. I need a new one. Regardless, the belt has to come off. And Church basically explained it to me. The way the belt works is, if you have a pulley, like on the alternator here, how it's ribbed, and the rib side goes on it, and this pulley here, it's flat, so the flat side of the belt rests on it. And that's how you know how to run your belt. So, it doesn't look too complex on this one here. Looks like the belt goes around this big pulley here, down to that bottom pulley there on the rib side, across here on the rib side, straight up off of this tensioner, and then down onto here, across onto the alternator, back down off of this, whatever this is, probably the water pump or steering pump. That looks like the steering pump there. Water pump is probably this one right here. Then down there is probably the main flywheel. I could be wrong on that. Like I said, not a mechanic, I'm just guessing. Yeah, I don't think this is something I want to touch today, people. Number one, I haven't done anything, and I'm sweating like a bitch. And number two, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. So, if you don't know what the fuck you're doing, you probably shouldn't do it. I might have to get a guy over to give me a hand, somebody who's familiar with this kind of shit. So maybe I'll go ahead and do the hose thing today. Get that done. So that sounds like a plan. Okay, so this here is the hose that hooks up to the tap. Here's my hose, and I hooked it up to this. So now, if I did this somewhat right, I should be able to crank this. I should suck in the hose and wrap it around the guy. What is this for? Okay, 1 second. There's something weird here. There's a piece of metal attached. I'm not sure what that's for. Okay, let me get you a... Oh, scampers just fell out of the window. Let me grab the instructions and see what the hell that is. Lock the crank handle in the open position. Yeah. Doesn't say anything about what those metal bits are. Okay, let me take a look at something. Alright, so these are to peg it down to the grass. They go in these holes back here. Then you can peg her down to the grass so that it doesn't run away on you. But it's going to be sitting right there, so I don't see the point in that. So I should be able to crank this, and we should start wrapping up the hose. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, because one-handed is not possible. I'm going to do it two-handed. The hose is attached. Everything looks good. I wish the hose hookup was on the other side, but I guess you can't have your cake and eat it too. Let's see what happens when we turn it on. Okay, well, it's working. Cool. Yeah, it's working. Just not right, so that's no good. That's no good. Good old yard work nozzle, eh? Garbage. But Yeah, same. Well, only one place for this thing to go. And that's straight in here. Bye-bye. Well, that's one less project to do. Nice. One of these days I gotta get working on this thing, get it all fixed up, gotta drain the fuel out of it. And one of these days, figure out what the fuck I did wrong with this thing. I don't feel like doing that today though. It's like the air is so thick right now that you can cut it with a knife. It's so muggy out. Fuck. I just realized I sucked the hose right through the, I'll have to fix that. But, push this thing back in here. I don't want to be out here very much longer. Ugh, this fucking chair, what am I going to do with you? I guess I'll put it back in the garage for now. Little garbage deal. Fucking chuck it out the side of the road. Get rid of it. Whatever. And the next time I'm at Walmart, I'll buy a new nozzle for my hose. At least now to disconnect the hose, it's easy. Just unscrew that. Oh yeah. There we go. The problem was this was loose, so when the door was putting pressure on it, it slid up and this here just jumped over the hoop and game over. Yeah, I'm gonna fix the hose, put the tripod away, and we'll head back in the house. As for that thing, I don't know. Look at her. She looks so unimpressed watching me. Oh, it's just me out. But, yeah, this fucking hose. We'll just kind of have that coming through like yonder. And I'll just have it laying down like that until I can get a new attachment for it. Next time I'm at Walmart or Canadian Tire, I'll buy one. But, yeah, we'll take the old trap hose, put it back in the garage for another day's use. Put you right here. Instructions can go there. Holy shit, that was like a friggin' two-pointer. These things I don't need for this project, but who knows? Might be useful for something else. Pack wrap mode, activate. And we're done out here. Nice. Almost tempted to mow the lawn again. But not really. I said almost. Alrighty, well, what the fuck is on my face? Oh, whatever. I'm gonna go and wash up and then have myself a Gatorade and edit up the footage. So, talk to you guys in a bit. Anywhoozle, I'm just editing up some footage from last night's GTA stream. I thought that was shit on my face. It's just on the camera. I'm setting up footage from last night's GTA live stream.
She's so pretty. Look at the kitty cat. Who's a pretty kitty? Who's a pretty kitty? Who's a pretty kitty? Yeah, you. Yeah, you. You're a pretty kitty. Meow, meow, meow. Meow, 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 meow. Meow, 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 meow. I got your black toe. I got your black toe. Meow, 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 meow.
But yeah, I was cutting up the videos. I'm gonna put those on Skaven Games because people do like watching the races, but don't really care about the banter in between. So I figured, frig it. I'll edit those up for Skaven Games while we stream on Vlogging Life, just like we used to do back when I was laid off. Seems like a good idea. But tonight for dinner, I was thinking steak. I'm gonna save that for tomorrow night. We're gonna do bangers and mash because that's delicious. I got these bangers here. We're gonna air fry them. I don't feel like going out to the garage. It's hot as shit out there. So we'll air fry some bangers, make some mashed potatoes. Should be awesome. Daddy, would you like some sausage? Daddy, would you like some sausage? Daddy, would you like? Daddy, would you like? Daddy, would you like some sausage? Couldn't spin my friggin' spice rack and didn't know why. The potatoes. Look at them. They've grown vines. That is fucking insane. They're trying to take root in my friggin' pantry. Alrighty, well, the potatoes are done. Just gotta wait on the bangers. And they got about 3 minutes remaining. shit. As I'm waiting here, all of a sudden Scampers gets into one of her moods where she gets mad at Oreo. She's like beating him up. He's like hiding beside me to keep me away from her, keep her away from me. Or him, I should say. So funny. She's just like, he's just sitting there. He's laying right here on the floor. And she just hauls off and clubs him one. No reason. Just because, you know, it's Saturday. Are you going after Oreo? No, okay. Thought she was about to dive bomb him. Poor Bubby, eh? Poor Bubby.
Oh, yeah. Air fried bangers. Lovely jubbly.
There you go. Bangers and mash. I'm going to go eat this, and then we're going to do some Grand Theft Auto live streams. So I'll talk to you guys later. Holy shit, guys. Fucking 4 o'clock in the friggin' morning. I am hammered out of my tits. I gotta clean my screen on this thing. That's disgusting. It looks like I got something on my face, but I don't. Screen's dirty. Did you guys hear that? Fucking birds are out. So, I'm gonna go take a piss right now. Well, that's stupid out. And I'm gonna shut this fucker down. You know, there's two types of people who watch the stream for trolling purposes. You got the people who watch, who actually make valid troll comments. Then you got the people who watch, who make the derpy ones, you know? Like, you're fat, which I love. I fucking love it when people call me fat. It's like, fuck, bro, you don't think I know this? And then you got the people who are like, you should kill yourself. How many times in the comments I get told to kill myself or to drink a pint of bleach? It's fucking hilarious. I think it's fucking mint. It just proves to me that society is pathetic when an individual has to sit there and actually tell people to kill themselves to make themselves feel better about their own lives. It's like, what the fuck is my dog doing? What are you doing, Oreo? Go potty. Let's go. Go potty. Let's go. Like right now. Shit. Go for a shit. Right now. I want to see you poop. Kangaroo up. Let's go. Thought I heard something down there. Anyway. That's right. You fucking pile drive one off, bud. We got things. Frig's sakes. But yeah, like seriously. You know how many times, how many comments don't make it to the actual comment thing? Because I have the word bleach blocked. KYS blocked. And kill blocked. Just so people can't tell me to kill myself. I don't need other people. I think it's funny. I don't need other people seeing that and actually being like, wow, how do you put up with this shit and stuff? It's like, I don't give a fuck. I just don't. What I do give a fuck is the fact that my dog's been kangarooing for a little bit there, and he's just having a rough one. He is squatting a fucking onion loaf like you wouldn't believe right now. But yeah, like, you're fat. Fuck, you don't think I don't know that I'm fat? You don't think I don't know that I got a gut? Come on. Fucking live with myself. I know what I got going on downstairs. Like, I give a fuck if people call me fat or stupid or whatever. Like, Jesus Murphy, I'm the fucking dummy putting these videos up on YouTube to begin with. You don't think I know what's going on? I know what's going on. Fuck, of course I know what's going on. But, yeah, you know what? I don't give a fuck. Because, stuff and junk. I don't know. Fuck, whatever. People are stupid. And they just want to trash talk, and let them trash talk. Fuck, it's whatever floats their boat, right? Either way, they gave me a view on my video. Probably a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Either way, that equals thumbs up for me, because that's audience engagement, and I love that kind. And it works to my benefit, so I don't give a fuck. But anyway, people, I'm going to shut this down here, so thanks for watching my video today. I really appreciate it. Sorry I couldn't do much with the Trans Am, but I found out some information. Apparently, if I take that pulley off, those three bolts in the front, that's four bolts right there, right? So I just drop the thumb in, three bolts in the front, kind of works. Pop that pulley off and it'll expose the bolts that I need. Pop that slut off and be done with it. Didn't know that. I know it now. Life is good. So, don't know when I'm going to get to that. Don't know what the weather's going to be like tomorrow. We'll wait, find out when we wake up. But anyway, people, I'm going to shut the vlog down here. I'm going to call it quits for tonight. So thanks for watching my video today. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, click that like button. Or if you didn't, click that dislike button. Click one of the two. Just don't fucking watch this shit and walk away. Click one of the two. And let me know what you thought. Leave a comment if you want to comment. And until next time, people, just fucking keep on vlogging. It's what I do.